Okay, what's up guys? So this week I'm doing two different videos, okay? In the first video I've done forged chassis. If you're not sure what forged chassis are, I'll put a link over here and in the description if you want to go check it out. And in this video I'm going to be showing you how to do forged crossovers, okay? Okay, so forged crossovers should look like this. Okay, so if you've never ever done forward crossovers before, the first thing you want to do is just stand along a line, okay? And I'm just going to do it along this blue line that's on curve, but just so you can see my feet. And what I want you to do is we're going to lean the right foot first, so you can do either, but I'm going to do my right. We're going to lean it over towards the little toe, because that's the direction I'm going to step over, okay? And as I step, I want to make sure I keep my feet nice and straight and my body square on to start off with. So I'm going to step and just carry on doing little steps going along in a straight line. Okay? And you do that both ways. So again, if you're doing the other side, over on that left side, leaning over towards your little toe, step all the way across. And again, leaning over, step all the way across, making sure we're keeping our feet nice and parallel so they're not twisting and turning. So once you've practiced that, we can move on and do it from moving as long as you're getting that in a nice straight line. So, when we do it moving, okay, you're going to start off on the outside edge on that left foot, both feet together. Again, we're going to bend our knees, making sure our hips, ankles and shoulders are nice and aligned and eyes up. To start off with, we're not going to worry about the arms too much, we're just going to have them straight ahead. And we're going to push off the ball of the foot with the right foot, so pushing off the inside edge. Okay, and we're going to push, step all the way across, and then you're going to lift your foot back together. Okay, so again, it's pretty much exactly the same as the chassis. You get your nice push, step across, and then lift that back foot so it goes up, down, and then you're just going to stand together on 2 feet, ready for your next push, step across. Okay, so it's quite simple. Bend those knees, push, all the way across, back together. Bend and push, cross, all the way back together. So again, that's exactly the same, going the other direction. You're going to be on the outside edge on your right foot. You get that nice push, step all the way across, lift the right foot up, down, back together with them feet nice and close. Okay? Now once you've got that, we're going to try and do a little bit of a stronger push. Okay? So we're going to go for more of an extent and make it look a little bit more professional, a little bit more elegant. Okay? So as we push, what we want to do is make sure our free leg, it's stretching out, and again, we're aiming for that good position with our back, so hips underneath, ankle and shoulders in line. As you push, you're gonna extend the free leg, and then from there, it's gonna be slightly out to the side. So the same as what I said in the chassis, we're gonna aim for roughly a 45 degree angle with your leg, because as you cross, instead of it stepping over the top now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna cut it in nice and neat, so it's staying a lot lower to the ice, and we're gonna try and lift the free foot, so we're getting a nice push, you're going to cross, keeping it lower, and then from there we're going to lift that free foot up. And when you lift your free foot up, what I want you to do is think about flexing your foot. Okay, so you're going to pull it off the toe to start off with, because again, like I said in the chassis video, a lot of people end up flicking with that back foot, and that is my biggest pet peeve. Really hate it. Okay, so we've got to make sure we don't have that, okay? So it comes across, and then I flex my foot up, down, back together. Okay, so next step, okay? You've got that nice little flex of that foot now, and you're pulling it off the ice nice and neat. The next thing I want you to do, okay, we're really going to try and stretch it out now, okay? So instead of just doing that little flex, okay, what we're going to try and do is we're going to try and cross more. And this is a word I use all the time when I'm doing these crossovers. Instead of just crossing and then lifting that foot up, we're going to try and cross, you down your knee, and you're going to try and get that foot as far across as you can while keeping your weight over your standing foot, okay? Because obviously this foot's going to be coming off the ice, yeah? So you've got to make sure you press it into the circle all the time. So as you cross more, it should look a little bit like this. We're really trying to stretch that leg out. So we're going for my crossover, get my nice push, and I cross more. So I'm getting that extension out of my free leg, and I cross more. Yeah? So I'm down on my knees and bringing my foot now, trying to keep it stretched out. Also, you should be doing your arms now a little bit. instead of just having them straight ahead, we're going to try and rotate the trunk of your body into the circle. Now, a lot of people try and just do the arms, and the upper body gets really stiff, so the arms are like this, and the shoulders push forward, and it's not the prettiest position, okay? What we want to do is just to start off with, get your arms down by your side. You're going to rotate your body in the circle as much as you can without rotating your feet. Now, what happens is now, my shoulders are in a nice line, okay? So from there, I can lift my arms straight out, and it's gonna be in the perfect position for crossovers. So I'm going from this left hand, it's got a nice straight line right the way through to the front arm, okay? That front arm's gonna stay in front the whole time, so it's pushing the direction that you want it to go, and the back arm's pushing the direction that you've just been, okay? So that's gonna give me a nice open stretch line. If you are struggling with that shoulder a little bit and it's pushing forward, the easiest thing to do is, if it's still forward when you're trying to get that rotation, is rotate your arm up and over the top, and that arm, the shoulder's just going to drop down, and it's going to get rid of that lump there. And voila, there you have it. Okay, so thank you very much for watching. If you'd like to subscribe, I'm going to put a subscribe button here. If you'd like to see last week's video, it'll be in the top corner over here. And thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next week. Bye!